lectures. Today we are going to take the topic phylum Arthropoda. Under this, we are going to discuss the basic characteristics of Arthropoda. Also, we will go through one diagrammatic representation of one of the arthropodans, that is centipede. Let's begin with the points, the basic characteristics of Arthropoda. First is, it is the biggest phylum. Okay, this is important. Which is the biggest phylum? Arthropoda is the biggest phylum and it contains around 90,000 species. So remember this thing. Next is the habitat. Habitat is in water, in land, in sea, in plants, in animals. Everywhere they can be found. So there is no limitation. Why is it so? Because it is the biggest phylum, so it's natural that it might be found in each and every habitat. Next is parthenogenesis is found in case of Arthropoda. What is parthenogenesis? The development of an unfertilized egg into an offspring. So when an unfertilized egg is developed into an offspring, this is known as parthenogenesis, and this parthenogenesis is found in Arthropoda. Next point is trilobites. This term trilobites. What is trilobites? The fossil Arthropoda is known as trilobite. Body of Arthropoda is bilateral, triploblastic, and with organ system. Okay, level of organization is organ system. Head is distinct and there is high degree of cephalization. So head is distinct and high degree of cephalization is found. Compound eye is found in case of Arthropoda, and this compound eye consists of many similar units known as omatidia. So a question might come, what is in which phylum Omatidia is found? So the answer is Arthropoda. Each compound eye is having lens and is capable of forming images. So it's also a distinct feature of Arthropoda that each eye is having a lens and they are capable of forming images. Next point is, Arthropoda have various shapes with extremely segmented body. Body is extremely segmented and they are divided into two. Either two region segmentation can be found or three region segmentation can be found. So two types of segmentations, either two region segmentation or three region segmentation. Under two region segmentation, head is there and trunk is there. So head and trunk, under two segments, under two region segmentation, the body is divided into head and trunk. Under three region segmentation, the body is divided into head, thorax and abdomen. Next, moving on. No internal segmentation. External segmentation is present in case of Arthropoda, but no internal segmentation is there. Internal segmentation was found in case of Annelida. The body wall consists of thick chitinous cuticle, and this cuticle is composed of protein and polysaccharide chitin, which is further strengthened by deposition of minerals. So this cuticle, the body wall consists of thick chitinous cuticle, and this cuticle is composed of protein and polysaccharide, and this is further strengthened by the deposition of minerals like calcium, phosphate and carbonate. So deposition of minerals like calcium, phosphate and carbonate is further strengthening this chitinous cuticle. Next is, flexible part of the cuticle is called suture. So there is one flexible ostium, that is anterior, mesenteron, that is middle, and protoproctodium, that is posterior. So the digestive